There's a plan.
Did you know
that human trafficking is the trade of humans for forced labor, sexual exploitation, domestic work, and others?
Nigeria is among the countries with highest number of victims, with over 1.3 million affected.
It happens in every state in Nigeria.
Human trafficking is happening very close to us.
Anyone can be a victim, be it rich, poor, whether in rural or urban centers.
At least 3 victims of human trafficking die every hour due to torture, disease, hunger, and neglect.
You need to observe and report human trafficking in your area. Volunteer or support Anti-Human Trafficking Project.
To support our Anti-Human Trafficking Project, contact 0814-184-9616 or 0903-000-2362 or visit www.devatop.org. This message is brought to you by Devatop with support from Institute for War and Peace Reporting and ICIR in partnership with Human Rights Radio 101.1 FM.
Humans for forced labor, sexual exploitation, domestic work, and others.
Nigeria is among the countries with highest number of victims, with over 1.3 million affected.
It happens in every state in Nigeria.
Human trafficking is happening very close to us.
Anyone can be a victim, be it rich, poor, whether in rural or urban centers.
At least 3 victims of human trafficking die every hour due to torture, disease, hunger, and neglect.
You need to observe and report human trafficking in your area. Volunteer or support Anti-Human Trafficking Project.
To support our Anti-Human Trafficking Project, contact 0814-184-9616 or 0903-000-2362 or visit www.devatop.org. This message is brought to you by Devatop with support from Institute for War and Peace Reporting and ICIR in partnership with Human Rights Radio 101.1 FM Abuja.
If you see us, talk us.
Yes, delighted to know you are still keeping your dial locked on Human Rights Radio 101.1 FM. It's still a very beautiful day right here in the FCT. And it's 10:03. It's time for us to go straight into the next program. And it is called TALKAM. Basically, it is a program that advocates, shows, basically, it goes against human trafficking and it explores the world of human trafficking. Brings out every danger, every implication, every consequences that basically the world is being faced by this deadly act, this menace that is being faced by the society. And as always, it's going to be a very, 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 very enlightening program. And it's not going to be just me in the studio. We have a whole team of experts right here who stormed the studio to help dissect this particular issue today. My name is Jordan, and let's go straight into introducing our host for today, Joseph Osigwe.
Oh, thank you so much, Jordan. Good morning, Nigeria. Good morning, our listeners and our viewers. You are welcome to TALKAM, a show against human trafficking on Human Rights Radio 101.1 FM Abuja. We thank you for being part of today's discussion. As just he said, my name is Joseph Osigwe, your host. And today we have very wonderful anti-human trafficking expert in the studio today. We have here Mr. Damarola Sunday Emmanuel. I hope I didn't murder his name.
It's okay.
Mr. Sunday, you're welcome.
Thank you very much.
We also have here, of course, Mr. Sunday is the president of a network of CSOs against child trafficking, abuse, and labor, in short form called NACTA. You're welcome, sir.
Thank you very much, and good morning, listeners.
Yeah. We also have here Mrs. Duru Regina. She's the executive director of Reggie and Henry Amazing Grace Foundation. Mrs. Regina.
Good morning, our listeners and our viewers. Nice to be here.
We now also have our Pidgin English coordinator. That's what I usually call her. She's also admin officer of Devatop Centre for Africa Development, Cynthia Ifanyi. Miss Cynthia, how are you doing?
I did fine, no. Thank you for when I don't come back to TALKAM for Human Rights Radio. When I do well. Thank you.
Okay, so today we'll be talking on a very interesting topic. People have assumed a lot about this topic, sex trafficking in Nigeria and abroad. You know, when you talk about human trafficking, a lot of people just assume it's just sex trafficking. And in Nigeria, when you talk of sex trafficking, people also assume it's only from Nigeria to Europe, but Nigerians are also trafficked within the country. So my first question will be going to Mrs. Duru. I would like you to tell us the meaning of sex trafficking and what are gays trafficked for, apart from sex trafficking? Are there other things that gays are trafficked for?
Yeah, thank you once again. You know, when we talk about sex trafficking, when you hear trafficking, you know it's an illegal migration of one thing or the other. So if you say sex trafficking, it means you're moving sex, you're migrating sex from this zone to another zone elsewhere. And of course, you know it's illegal. And now when you talk about other things that girls do, you know it's not even only girls that go for this migration or being trafficked for sex.
Yes.
Even guys too. I hope you know about anal sex. Yes. I hope you know about anal sex, but it's too common. When we talk about sex trafficking, just your mind goes to women, girls. It's more than that. Now, girls are not just being trafficked there for just sex. You know, there's something you in trafficking you call the demand and supply.
Yes.
In demand and supply is what the enders want, that you occasionally hear that the victims are being trafficked for.
Yes.
If you hear of fertility, they need fertility, there may be surrogacy, they need ovaries, they need eggs.
You mean they can be trafficked and their ovaries are taken or the eggs are
taken? Definitely. Of course, if you're a victim of human trafficking, you don't own yourself anymore. You're used for anything. Anything. You can just there before your eyes, your organs are being taken. There before your eyes, your ovaries are being taken, you can do nothing. You're a victim and you're helpless. So when our girls are being trafficked, they are used for all manner of things. From my research, I have seen that even from within the country.
Yes.
Even from within the country, like I work with some group of sex workers. My organization will work with sex workers in different slums. You know, by the time you gain their confidence, they open up and they tell you a lot of things happening to them. Right there in slums, right here in Nigeria. When we talk of trafficking, we're thinking of Europe, Libya.
Yes.
Right here in this country.
Yes.
I have been to a slum where somebody is telling me, please, madam.
In Abuja here?
Right here in Abuja. Please, madam, don't say I told you. But I'm here under this coverage. I am trafficked from my village to this place. My mother actually gave me out so that I can be getting returns and be helping
this
my family.
Terrible.
Now, ma, please, what I'm here to do is that I service men, and there are some people who come and they beg my madam that let me give birth for some other people. I do that. I've done that 2 times. And now there are people who also say they need something from my stomach. I don't know exactly what it is. I said, what is it like? She explained, and I discovered and I suspected it was either her ovary or her eggs. So there are so much going on that we don't know that is not even talked about.
Yes.
Sex trafficking is a booming business. Outside drugs.
Yes.
Is about the second business.
Largest,
income.
Illegal.
Yes. Very illegal. Thank you, it's so booming.
Thank you for giving justice to that. Also for revealing that apart from sexual exploitation, girls are trafficked and their ovaries and eggs are taken. Thank you. Let's come to Mr. Emmanuel. Mr. Emmanuel, why are girls trafficked for sexual purposes? Why, what's the cause of this? And then what do you think can be done to prevent sex trafficking?
Thank you very much. Sex, as we all know, it's the normal thing between a man and a woman. And it's often done in secrecy.
Yes.
That is how the nature
yes.
made it. But presently, because of like what Madame just said, demand and supply, some statistics or some literatures said the reason why some of the some European countries, especially in Italy, Spain, yes. and some other Netherlands and the likes, they said they prefer the black girls because the black girls are stronger,
really?
They are sexually active, unlike the white ones, and they have better body. Like the white ones. Those are some wow. of the reasons. So that is a push factor
yes.
From the from European countries. And so when that demand is there, hence there are some people that want to make money, not minding if anyone is dead or not.
Yes.
So because of that, they also tend to supply. That is one. Secondly is this, poverty or economic challenges also is one of the factors that is pushing this. You just had a woman pushing a girl into sex slavery because yeah. they want to make an ends meet. And hence, where there are problems with meeting daily needs,
yes.
people tend to use what they, some people tend to use what they have to get what they want. And so that is another reason why a lot of people or some people venture into that. And then when you look at the idea of mental illness,
yes.
Mental illness went on, someone could not think right or reason right. That's why we have a lot of people now going after young girls, children, pedophiles, because they are mentally ill. That's also
again,
and they want to have sex with 2 years. And the in thing again is this, just about 3 weeks ago, this came to my table, that some people get moved by having sex with pregnant women. And you can imagine a lot of things, mentally ill people. So that's another thing. Mental illness makes also people to get involved in yeah. that. And then again, the peer influence is another factor. Peer pressure.
Yes.
Everybody is doing it. I need to do it. I want to feel belong, especially in secondary schools and in primary schools and in higher institutions as well. So you see people getting involved in being trafficked for sex simply because they want to belong. And unfortunately, they would have gotten to a point of no return
yeah.
before they realized that.
Well, what do you think can be done to
now, looking at what can be done to prevent this, one of the things is this. Charity, they said, begins at home.
Yes.
The parents need to actually train, tutor, educate, and provide the right information for children right from younger age.
Yes.
Secondly is this. We need also to sensitize people about the true state of things, especially people moving from one place to the other.
Yes.
Today, you see, I mean, I got to a particular community. You have a whole house. They call it Calabar for Calabar sex. This house is meant for Calabar girls. You get another place, they say Benue joint. You get another place, they say Edo house.
Yes.
You say, and these are tribes by tribes. So we need, sincerely, to let people understand that this is what is happening by sensitization, awareness, and making people to understand the real thing. Second thing. Now, thirdly, we need also to enforce the law.
Yes.
The NAPTIP Act and then the Child's Rights Law and other things. We need to enforce
violence against persons.
Exactly, violence against persons since 2015. We need also to enforce it. And thirdly, there is need for education.
Yeah.
There are education, we concentrate more today on certificate.
Not on the real thing.
Not on the real thing. So education, that's the reason why like this network, SAKEFA, has been saying, look, apart from looking at the curriculum of English, mathematics and that, we need to also add some other things. Entrepreneurship, we need to add moral training and the likes of our academics.
Right. Okay,
so that will build children also and prevent all these things.
All right, thank you. Let's come to Cynthia. Cynthia, I know you have something to say about this.
Okay, my people for house, when I don't hear them, they don't use Oyibo to scatter everything, but make we bring them down. They just tell them, say, if they over your say, in your daily life, if they see people around, they move them from one place to another. Nobody will to move them from Nigeria, go Europe, not be saying that they go there for sex trafficking. No. As Madam don't talk for a line of work as a social worker, she don't see, say, even if they move people from villages, come big cities, all for sexual exploitation.
Yes.
Wait till people they call sexual exploitation and to call stable road. They actually they meet men, they collect money, not be just to meet men. I understand what they try to talk. But we they as activists and anti-human trafficking advocates, we they here to educate people to make una know say these things they happen within our quarrel. If you see one quarrel for there, you go to say nothing they happen, but you on your own, you don't suspect say group of young ladies, group of teenage girls, they come there for that particular place. Every night, you go there, yes, some kind, some maybe say on the norms, you know, day normal for a year. But you on your own, wait till you don't do as citizen of the country. Because we go for one seminar yesterday as it relates to gender-based violence. Maybe say issues may concern women for the community.
Yes.
You can't say, Nigeria, we get this culture of silence. And we get this culture of na family matter.
Yes.
And we get this culture of, you know, consign me, not be my matter, so it not affect you. It not affect you today, it affect your neighbor today. What it not affect you today, it go turn around, it affect you tomorrow.
Definitely.
It affect your one of your relatives tomorrow. So these are things maybe say we as Devatop, as anti-human trafficking advocate don't come in partnership with Human Rights Radio. These are something maybe say everybody need to come put hands together, more could touch like this kind of issues. And we could say, I want to pull resources together to make this kind of programs like this, sustain this kind of program. So that we go educate our people for us, say, if they see something, may they talk.
Thank you, Cynthia. So we'll be going for a short break. Please stay tuned to Human Rights Radio 101.1 FM Abuja.
101.1 Radio.
Welcome aboard the Human Rights Radio.
Redefining broadcasting.
There's a plan.
Did you know
that human trafficking is the trade of humans for forced labor, sexual exploitation, domestic work, and others?
Nigeria is among the countries with highest number of victims, with over 1.3 million affected.
It happens in every state in Nigeria.
Human trafficking is happening very close to us.
Anyone can be a victim, be it rich, poor, whether in rural or urban centers.
At least 3 victims of human trafficking die every hour due to torture, disease, hunger, and neglect.
You need to observe and report human trafficking in your area. Volunteer or support Anti-Human Trafficking Project.
To support our Anti-Human Trafficking Project, contact 0814-184-9616 or 0903-000-2362 or visit www.devatop.org. This message is brought to you by Devatop with support from Institute for War and Peace Reporting and ICIR in partnership with Human Rights Radio 101.1 FM Abuja.
If you see us,
talk up.
Absolutely, still Human Rights Radio 101.1 FM right here in the FCT, and the program has been TALKAM on Human Rights Radio. Basically, the program centers its attention on the menace of human trafficking being faced by the society at large. And so far, we've had expert opinions and we have been able to dissect issues concerning human trafficking. Welcome back. It continues right about now. Let's start on this, resume on this notes. Now, we've heard, you know, just how much it affects the society at large, just how much, you know, it takes a toll on, you know, the Nigerian society, that not just the Nigerian society, but basically globally. Now,
is there
any form of mentality that is prone to this particular menace? Like, are there certain people, certain type categories or certain type of people that are prone to this menace, or is every single person generally affected, or are there just basically certain people with certain mentalities that are basically, you know, vulnerable to, you know, this menace?
Well, Jordan, thank you very much. You know, one thing that is very clear is this. When you look at each bracket of people that are sexually active,
yes,
then you look at people younger age, 20, 15. But now it's even getting younger, 10 years old.
Yeah.
And so that is one. Then secondly, you look at tradition. Tradition, people's value, community norms.
Yes.
That's the reason why today Edo is on top of the old 51% of people that are returned back to Nigeria from Edo.
Yes. And, but now it's shifting now. You know
it's
that
not, it's not moving because the traffickers are now moving to other yes. like that. I told some guys from the European Union recently. Yeah. I said, listen, we are concentrating on Edo, but look at the surroundings because that's where the traffickers are moving now. So you look at, because the understanding of people in Edo is this, go, your sister make money for Netherlands
yes.
and come build us. So you too, you can't go, yes. no matter what you do there. So that is one of the areas. So geographically, you look at the value of people that are now making it. And then lastly, you look at areas in Abuja here, early we used to see somebody that is average earners pushing their children into that place. So where poverty is high, definitely you expect high level yeah. of people being pushed into sex trafficking.
I think we'll just hold on here and then open our line so that people can call and ask questions or contribute. So our phone line is open. You can call us on 090-30-00-2362. I call it again, 090-30-00-2362. One more thing, Joshua. You know, last week, after the radio program, we had a report of a 13-year-old girl who was abused, and then she was in the hospital, and when the call came to us, we contacted NAPTIP, and within 2 hours, the perpetrator was arrested.
That's great.
So I encourage everyone listening to us to call and ask questions. If you have any report you sense that somebody has been trafficked, please feel free to call us so that we can help. Also, when you're calling, try to give us detail. We can even call you back to get detail because that will help us to facilitate investigation. We have a caller here. Okay. So that is it because, you know, the essence of TALKAM is not just to talk, it's also to take action.
Yes, and we have an alternative line for you to reach yes. out to as well. And the other line is 081-8999-1011.
We have a caller here. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Hello, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning to you. What's your name?
My name is Daniel.
Daniel, welcome to the program.
I want to know, is there any compensation on anybody that has been a man or a woman is being caught? You give the report. Is there any compensation?
Mm.
Any compensation for anyone who reports?
Yes, basically, like whoever okay. Reports cases like this,
like
the whistleblowing thing.
Okay,
yes.
My brother, thank you very much for saying that. You see, the ideology is that nothing goes for nothing.
Yes.
But I want to tell you sincerely that your compensation is even more than naira and kobo, because once you report, you save life.
Yes.
And the, like what my brother said earlier this morning is this. It might not affect you today.
Yes.
It might eventually affect you tomorrow. I've seen a case of someone that was infected HIV, and eventually the person that's supposed to help and prevent it then just looked the other way. After about 15 years, the same girl, the son of the man, brought the girl back home. That is the girl I want to marry.
Mm-hmm.
And the guy insisted. So one of the compensation is this, my brother, is that you get blessed by God.
Yes.
You get reward by humanity. And lastly, also your conscience will give you that you have done the right thing.
Yeah.
Naira and kobo, no. No program for such now.
Let's hear from this. Hello?
Hello, good morning.
Yeah, good morning.
Yes, my name is Lawa.
Okay, Lawa, you're welcome.
I'm calling you from
Yeah.
Please, the problem I have, not for you to upload you.
Okay.
But what is the reaction? You see, when you go and report somebody, at the end of the day, there is nothing done about it. They don't encourage you to.
Okay, the call just ended. So he's complaining most times you report and nothing is done about it. And that is why a TALKAM program is unique. For every report we get, we make sure we investigate and also reach to the end point of it. So we encourage you one to the first thing is just to report. Then
it's like Jordan, we have a call.
Okay. Yes, we have a call right there. Hello, good morning. Good morning to you too, sir. Welcome to the program.
My name is Ibrahim Dennis.
All right, so welcome. Go right on.
Mister, I want to ask you a question.
Go ahead.
Like the human trafficking.
Yes.
If you see a neighbor is treating a child, whether they bring somebody to him, he's treating. Somebody you can still call report. But if you call report, you can take my name to tell the case and say, look at the case where you bring the name. After this year program, you are very good.
Yes.
Why you not support the translation with the Hausa, Igbo, Yoruba, because some people they don't understand the program. Not everybody don't understand the program. Make it a try to do that three language. Please, thank you very much.
And thank you very much for that suggestion.
Okay. I understand why that man just called now. They talk, say, make we actually break them down. Now I make idea here because most of my colleague here, what people they call, most of my fellow here, all of them are big Oyibo that they speak. So me, I they carry them calm down to localize them. Pidgin are like one of our general language, maybe say everybody, they feel the yarn. So, and human trafficking, are waiting to say you and me could come together to come help solve the problem. And I make with a preach, say, if you see them, make you talk them.
Yeah, so thank you. Even if, as time goes on, we might also include Hausa and for those that don't even understand English and Pidgin. So let's hear from this caller. Yeah, hello.
Hello, good morning.
Yeah, good morning.
Well done. My name is Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you. Go ahead.
What about those people like how who would like information? What part of the government they are like that receiving?
Oh.
I think we lost the
chance.
Okay,
yeah,
madam,
what's
you. You heard what he said?
No.
Oh, okay.
We have another call right here. Let's speak. Hello. Good morning.
Hello. Good morning, sir.
Good morning to you too, sir. Welcome to the program.
Yeah, my name is Ethan Abraham. Calling from Wasa Apo Extension.
All right. Pleasure to have you. Go right on.
Yeah. You're welcome. Yeah. The problem where most people have is when you report. Especially when you report to the police will attend, they will not come, at times they will come, even if they come, if they arrest the person, after all said and done, they will tell the person that is the person that reported you, that you should be careful with that person.
Yes.
Why police supposed to hide the identity of the reporter? You understand? They will still tell the person, say, that this person reports you, so be careful with them. Police, they are not encouraging people to report.
All right, thank you very much. Thank you, thank you for being a part of the program this morning.
Yeah, I think that at this point, that's why we'll talk about this partnership, at least with the gender unit of the police force. I know that there was this case. Well, it was a violent domestic violence.
Yes.
Issue. I personally took to gender issue of police, and the way they treated it, in fact, I got satisfied. And I see that from that end, that their gender section, that there's this awareness creation that they are giving out to the public.
Yes.
Where you have that issue is where they are not trained, people in that unit. In fact, we had this summit with them, and we said, if when you train this particular kind of people, before you move them out from that unit, retrain others.
Yes.
Make sure that anybody in that unit is trained. Yes. Somebody can just behave like this when he or she is not trained.
Yeah.
No sense of professionalism. Yeah. Because if there is, it's not something that you use to try to end a relationship.
Yeah.
No. This is a very serious matter.
We have to cut it short here because of time.
Let me just quickly add this. Also, if it is issue of trafficking, please get in touch with NACTIB.
Of course, Just as you're listening to this radio talk, you can also report and we engage NAPTIP. Of course, NAPTIP is legally empowered to address issues of human trafficking. So thank you for being with us today. Please tune into the same radio station on Friday by 10 a.m. If you see TALKAM.
Absolutely. Thank you for being a part of the program this morning. It takes me and you to fight this menace being faced by the society. And for those looking for rewards, there's absolutely no room for that. However, the big question you should ask is if it happens to one of your own, yes, will you be happy? Just maybe that would stir the kindness in you to want to join up in the fight against this. And like they did say, same time, well, the program would make a return. However, do stick around and keep your dial locked on Human Rights Radio 101.1.
Welcome on board to the Human Rights Radio.
Redefining broadcasting.
There's a place.
Did you know
that human trafficking is the trade of humans for forced labor, sexual exploitation, domestic work, and others?
Nigeria is among the countries with highest number of victims, with over 1.3 million affected.
It happens in every state in Nigeria.
Human trafficking is happening very close to us.
Anyone can be a victim, be it rich, poor, whether in rural or urban centers.
At least 3 victims of human trafficking die every hour due to torture, disease, hunger, and neglect.
You need to observe and report human trafficking in your area. Volunteer or support Anti-Human Trafficking Project.
To support our Anti-Human Trafficking Project, contact 0814-184-9616 or 0903-000-2362 or visit www.devatop.org. This message is brought to you by Devatop with support from Institute for War and Peace Reporting and ICIR in partnership with Human Rights Radio 101.1 FM Abuja.
If you see us, talk to us.